master was easy to connive. Just grab a hoe and mourn his work and he assumed he owned you. So from plantation to plantation I went, teaching amongst a chosen few. Arithmetics, mathematics, and African spirituality in the wee hours of the night. To make a long story short, I infiltrated the slave master's main house. Equipped with the finesse of a Black Panther, we was able to retrieve guns and ammunition. I organized, fought, and died in one of the most biggest known slave revolts on American soil. And although dead in the flesh, I have lived in the spirit and followed the progress of my African people. And that's why I felt the need to send this newsletter through one of my most dangerous, trusted Negroes, bearing a message to all brave enough to step up and take the challenge. Dangerous Negroes wanted and needed. Black power.
Black power.
That was deep. I really like that.
Dangerous Negroes, man.
Start posting this shit.
Yeah.
Man, that dashiki fresh though, man. Where you get that at?
Raw hemp, pipes and necessities. We carry these jars straight from Africa, straight from God. You know what I'm saying? I'm out here with my people. All praise due to the Most High, Rastafari, Abba Selassie.
How do they connect with you to get them, you know?
Man, you can inbox me. I'm on the Rastafari Tafari on a book. You can inbox me on a web page over there at Raw Hemp. We got the website on the way. Obviously, you can hit any of my comrades that you link with, man. We very well connected. They can get you to me. They can get the order made for you. And, yeah, we just follow them with Jot Works, man. We out here representing, I represent the Rastafari aspect of Black Power, and we just out here letting the people know, because it's a lot of misunderstandings dealing with Rastafari, so we letting them know that Rastafari is Black Power. Do not get it twisted, you know what I'm saying? Rastafari is Garveyites. We have a direct lineage to Garvey, for he prophesied the coming of a Black King. In 1928, when he told them to look to the east for the crown of a Black King, for the day of redemption was near. 2 years later, Haile Selassie was crowned King of Ethiopia. So all of our pro-Black movements come from Garveyite. So we just connecting the dots and we breaking down the stereotype. Rastafari is not no Jamaican cult or following, even though a lot of our ancestors there were the first ones to adhere to the message, being Jamaicans are still about 97% African bloodline, you know what I'm saying? So it's easier for them to adapt to an African spirituality, you know what I'm saying? So. Definitely. Just letting them know that Rastafari is an African movement. It's a pan-African movement to where we look to the east, and our following is in the motherland. When you say you Rastafari, understanding that Rastafari is a culture and that you're agreeing that you lost your true name, your true language, and your true African spirituality in the slave trade process. So we look back to the motherland for the truth, the way, the light, and the understanding. So yeah, that's what I'm representing, just the Black Power aspect of Rastafari. And linking with my RBG comrades and just letting them know we all one people.
Black owned business. Hell yeah, bro. We love that.
We got one called Law though. Law. I have come to the conclusion that law stands for the legal authority of whites. So with no law broken, they saw fit for law to be created. So basically, we broke the law by simply stepping off the foot on American soil. A law created for white people by white people, and you wonder why we always on the opposite end of the law. Any attempt to free yourself up spiritually, mentally, or religiously were the founding principles of the law. Any African action from that point on made the law what it is today. Challenge the legal authority of whites in any way, brothers and sisters, and I tell you, you have broken the law.
Right. And when we call these things laws, these as if they're like arbitrary, they're like more so like arbitrary rules, you know what I mean? Because real laws can't be broken, you know what I mean? Real laws can't be changed or ignored. And that's one thing that Black people are missing, is that understanding of the natural laws in which the universe operates and shit. But anybody else got anything? We live at Vegan Soul.
It's time to take it to the next Black-owned business. Yeah. Where we going, Ken?
Detroit Vegan Soul.
We're going to Nani's. Tell them about it. Another Black-owned business. We're going to go support, man.
Yeah,
man. Nani's Knowledge Cafe.
So what y'all think about?
Let's get the check.
So Detroit Vegan Soul. Detroit Vegan Soul, what you got for it?
You see a nigga over there still cleaning his garbage. That thing was righteous.
Are you a vegan?
Not at all.
Does this place make you miss anything?
Not at all.
Does it leave you unfulfilled?
The fried tofu and waffles on my ears, chicken and waffles. The DVS breakfast sandwich. Flavors blend better than any breakfast sandwich I had with any meat, cheese, otherwise on it. The sweet potato pancakes I just had. A1. Stop playing with Detroit, y'all, man. Come and support our people. And get fed and nourished very well. Black power.
Black power. Red's over there building. Instantly. We out here building in the D, man.
It's KLX.
We actually have our own civilization and we are living amongst each other with the fight that, and the shit that we have to do with fighting this beast. A lot of our hearts are going to get hardened. So when we do get it to where we at, we need to preserve that love.